If you're looking for insight into Unity's input system and how to do action mapping, well, I'm going to be explaining it today from the perspective of a VR developer. I want to keep this tutorial quick, simple, and easy for anyone. All we are going to do is find the menu button on the Oculus controller. We're going to press it and it's going to pop open a menu. That's it. If you want to follow along using my VR template, you can find it in the description below. Or if you're using the XR Interaction Toolkit, you should be able to follow along too. So let's hop in. Coming into the project, again, this is my VR template, but you can follow along in your own project if you'd like. All I've done here is duplicate this blank scene. I've changed the name to the scene to mapping inputs, and I've just added my main canvas prefab that I have in here. Let's see. Yeah, and I've just dragged this in, and I've just changed some of the words here for funsies. So let's talk about the input system. So if you're going to make an input system, it's as easy as right-clicking, going to create, and then going down to input actions. And this will create your input system. So I could just put input system here, and let me double-click it and open it up. And you can see we have a few things here. We have action maps, and we have actions. And this is where a lot of the magic goes on with this new input system. Let's have the example of a game where you have space exploration, but you can also land on planets and walk on foot. So you might have two different action maps. You can have one called Spaceship and then one called On Foot. Not great naming convention there for On Foot, but you know, whatever. We're going to go with this. And for the spaceship, we could have a bunch of different actions that do different things. You're in a spaceship, you'll have a boost, you can fly around. On foot, walking around, it's going to be like WASD. And so for this, we could have different actions for different situations, whether on foot or inside the spaceship. And this is where the magic is too with the actions. So now we can just choose an action, let's say boost, and then we could apply a bunch of different bindings. So it's more device agnostic. It no longer has to worry about, are they using a keyboard, a gamepad, touchscreens, whatever. We can add all the different bindings we want to this singular action. And just to round this out, let's just say, what should we have this be? Space, spacebar. There we go. And so if I press spacebar, that would activate the boost for the spaceship if I coded it. But we are doing VR development, and we would normally have to map all this out to make our VR inputs work with our headsets and stuff, but luckily, we already have an input system. Now, if you're not using the XR Interaction Toolkit or don't know what I'm talking about, please go check out my input system video, which will help explain that a little better. I'm going to go ahead and exit out of here. And oh, here's one for you. Always make sure you save your input systems. There's been many times I've made 100 changes, and then I forget to save, and I lose all my progress. So I'm just going to save that. Now, the one that comes with the XR Interaction Toolkit samples, if we type in input, it'll bring up the XRI default input actions. And you can see here it has a ton of action maps for us already. Our objective in this tutorial is to get this menu over here to turn on and off when we hit the menu button. So which menu button should we hit? Do we want the left hand or the right hand? Well, sadly, the right hand menu button is kind of reserved when it comes to the Oculus Quest, and it's kind of becoming the standard that the right hand menu button is off limits. And so that leaves us the left hand. So I'm going to go to left hand interactions. I'm going to add an action. I'm going to call it menu. And so we need to add a menu binding. So we are going to come over here. And oddly enough, you have to hit right click to go forward in the menu here. So XR controller left hand, usages. And then we come here and we have to choose one of these. Now, my understanding is the menu is more of like the general reference to a command input. So a application or something's using the context of the menu, say a gesture or voice command or doing some form of hand tracking, then that would be this binding. And then the menu button is more specific to the button itself. And then finally touch is when you just kind of touch over it and it can detect that. So I'm going to choose menu button because I find menu to be a little ambiguous. And then on top of that, we also want to set this to generic XR controller. And so now we have an action on our left-hand interaction. And when we hit the menu button, it is going to call this action. So that is set up there. And we just need to exit, make sure we save. And now we have to wire it up to this. Now to do that, like always, I have a script. So I'm going to open that up really quick. And I've called it menu controller. If you want, I'll attach this script onto my Patreon. And it's available to all my Patreon members. But you can also just follow along in the video. And this is the menu controller script, and it's fairly simple. So a funny thing you have to do first is, first we need to make sure we're using the input system, and we're going to grab a reference to our specific action we want to use. So this is going to be that menu action that we just created. And then we also want to grab the game object so we can turn it on and off. Now you'll see on Awake that I do one thing. I take the open menu action and I enable it. And you can see on Destroy, I also disable it. So the new input system likes to have its actions enabled and disabled when you are and aren't using them. And if you don't do that, sometimes it gets a little cranky. So always be aware of it. And you can see here, I also subscribe to two different events. We have an event for when I am toggling the menu, and it comes down here, and we have a input action dot callback context. And so this is just the signature that you need to subscribe to the action dot performed. And so whenever this action is performed, the open menu action, it is going to call this function. And all we do is, well, set the menu active or not. Now, another one that I subscribe to is also on device change. So I subscribe to that and it comes down here and we handle that. And the reason I do that is because a lot of the times the controllers are active and inactive when it comes to developing or playing VR games. Sometimes people put them down, you're switching controllers or going from controllers to hand tracking. And so this is how I handle that change. So you can see when the device either becomes disconnected, it's going to come in here, it's going to disable the action, and then it's going to unsubscribe from that event right here. On top of that, we have it when it reconnects, it just enables and resubscribes. And that's really it. All we have to do now is come back to the editor and hook things up and see if it's working. I already have the menu panel there. And then we need to have our input action, and we called it menu. There it is, the XRI left-hand interaction menu. And let's save it and see what we have. Okay, and you can see that I am able to move around, and if I press the menu button on my left hand, it disappears, and if I hit it again, it reappears. So there you go, it is that shrimple. Now, I know this was a simple tutorial for just hitting the menu button, opening up a menu, but don't be afraid to go in here and see how all of these are made and how you can apply it whenever you want to, well, choose a button to activate something in your game. So there you have it, how you map a button to an action that you want. Patreon members, without you, I can't do this. So thank you as always, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye-bye.